What are you doing?
You know, Mike, many people think that stars and planets move through the universe rather like these bubbles from the gun, very gently and sedately. But they're wrong.
They are wrong. Imagine my hand is the sun, and these are planets. One of them is the Earth. The Earth actually moves around the sun at a blistering 66,000 miles per hour.
Wow. What about the sun?
What about the sun? Well, it moves around the core of the Milky Way galaxy at about 500,000 miles per hour.
That's pretty fast. But it's a lot faster than bubbles.
A lot faster than bubbles, but it's not the fastest thing that we know about. There are other stars, individual stars, that go at 1,000,000 miles an hour or more.
How do you get them to go that fast, though?
Well, first you start with a black hole, a supermassive black hole. Can you bring in a binary star for me, please?
As a matter of fact, I can.
So when a binary star approaches a black hole and gets too close, what can happen is that one of the stars gets swallowed, and the other goes flying out of the galaxy at 1,000,000 miles an hour, maybe more than that.
That's as fast as we can go, right? That's as fast as we see things going in the universe, big macro scale objects.
It is not. This black hole, you would imagine, it weighs 1,000,000,000 times as much as a star. And you would think it couldn't move fast at all. But you would be wrong. We have discovered at least one black hole that seems to be exiting its galaxy at 4 or 5 million miles per hour.
And how the heck is that going to happen, though? How are we going to explain that?
Well, this black hole might have been the product of a merger between two slightly smaller black holes. And when they merge together, they emit a burst of gravitational waves. And the kick from those gravitational waves actually launched this black hole out into space at that insane speed.
So less bubbles, more one of these?
Yeah, more like that.
Wow.
But that's not all. If it happened once in the history of the universe, it probably happened thousands of times or millions of times. And what that means is that there are almost certainly giant black holes weighing billions of times as much as a star flying around the universe right at this moment, and we can't even see them.
In which case, it's really a lot more like this, isn't it? We have to watch out for the black holes.
Yeah. For Scientific American, I'm Mike Lemonick.
And I'm Lee Billings.
Please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
So in that case, it's more like... Woo! 2 came out! That's crazy!
Okay, we get it.